Lord, be present. Render me faithfully and loyally serve you. Bring back the wonders of mind and the boldness of heart. Our keen affection will worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
At the procession soft music.
Thank you.
have no other gods but me. Response: Amen. Lord, have mercy. You shall not make for yourself any idol. Amen. Lord, you shall not invoke or bow the name of the Lord your God.
Amen.
Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy.
Amen.
Honor your father and your mother.
Amen.
You shall not commit murder.
Amen.
You shall not commit adultery.
Amen.
You shall not steal. You shall not be a false witness.
Amen.
You shall not convert anything that belongs to your neighbor.
Amen.
The first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God is the Lord. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this. If we say we have no sins, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us confess our sins against God and our God. Most of you might go to God. We confess that we have sinned against you. That we have done. I truly sorry and humbly repent for the sake of your Son Jesus Christ. Have mercy on us and forgive us. We delight in the rhythm and walk in the peace. Almighty God, have mercy upon us, forgive us all our sins. Strengthen us in all goodness by the power of the Holy Spirit. Keep us in eternal life.
Amen.
Shall we kindly stand? O sinning victim, open wide. Page 20, 17, 6, 17.
A reading from the 20th chapter of the book of Exodus.
Exodus chapter 20, verses 1 through 17. God spoke to Moses on Mount Sinai, saying, I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself a graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the waters under the earth. You shall not bow down to them or serve them, for I am the Lord your God and a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the father upon the children to the third and the fourth generation of those who hate me, but showing steadfast love to thousands of those who love me and keep my commandments. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain, for the Lord will not uphold him guiltless who takes his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. In it you shall not do any work, you or your sons or your daughters, your manservants or your maidservants, or your cattle, or the sojourner who is within your gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, and rested the seventh day. Therefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long in the land which the Lord your God gives you. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or his manservant, or his maidservant, or his ox, or his ass, or anything that is your neighbors. The words of the Lord. The psalm appointed for the third Sunday in Lent is Psalm 19, verses 7 to 14. Book of Common Prayer, page 607. The psalm will be chanted by the choir while the congregation remains seated.
Thank you.
beginning at the 13th verse. Romans chapter 7, verses 13 to 25. The that which is good bring death to me? By no means. It was sin working death in me through what is good, in order that sin might be shown to be sin, and through the commandment might become sinful beyond measure. We know that the law is spiritual, because I am carnal, sold under sin. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now, if I do what I do not want to do, I agree that the law is good. So then, it is no longer I that do it, but sin which dwells in me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. For I do not do what I want, but the evil I do not want to do is what I do. Now if I do not want to do, it is no longer I who do it, but sin which dwells in me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do right, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self, but I see in my members another law at war with the law of my mind and making me captive to the law of sin which dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will deliver me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. So then, I of myself serve the law of God with my mind, but with my flesh I serve the law of sin, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gradually, God of grace and God of glory, to the music of C.M. Brunner, is found on page 34 of our songbook.
Thank you.
according to John chapter 2, beginning at the 13th verse. The Passover of the Jews was at hand, and Jesus went up Jerusalem. In the temple, he found those who were selling oxen and sheep and pigeons, and the money changers at their business. And making a whip of cords, he drove them all with the sheep and oxen out of the temple. And he poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And he told those who sold the pigeons, "Take these things away. You shall not make my father's house the house of trade." His disciples remember that it was written, "Zeal for their house will consume me." The Jews then said to him, "What sign have you to show us for doing this?" Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple in 3 days and I will raise it up." The Jews then said, "It has taken 46 years to build this temple. Will you raise it up in 3 days?" But he spoke of the temple of his body. When therefore he was raised from the dead, the disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word which Jesus had spoken. The gospel of the Lord.
In the blood of the Lamb for the Museum of Elisha E. Upham is found on page 4 of our bulletin. After the singing of this beautiful hymn, our sermon will be brought to us by the clergy who is highly motivational and by the celebration of good Christian and moral character in person of Reverend Father Madam Francis Seal, our precious writer, who will preach to us on the day, "Take these things out of here in the mighty name of Jesus."
Oh, of the land. Open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim thy praise. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good morning, St. Thomas. God is good. And all the time, the God is good and great. We are going to offer this morning. And wonderful and marvelous God is walking in our praise. In Jesus' name. Let me welcome all of you on this first Sunday of March. And we thank God that He has brought us this far. And the same God that brought us this far will take us through no matter what the condition may be. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
I'd like to start by telling you something of myself. Growing up as a child, I hated one day of the week. And that day is Saturday. Because when you think that you're about to sleep because there's no school that day, you have to wake up at 6 if you are in a real room then, and that Tuesday was to clean the floor from the living room to the porch. And of course, you want to promise the floor as a young man, you know what I'm talking about, young people. You want to clean the floor quickly, and what people will say in the make of a blow. You will clean the floor and then you report. And if you have a mother like myself who can smell and see, forget it. When she goes to inspect and just small dust from the bookshelf or the place that will be clean, it will be scrubbed the floor. But this morning, we are presented with three lessons. In our first passage, from the book of Exodus, we are presented with the Decalogue that was just read, we recited a few minutes ago. God had brought the children of Israel from the bondage of slavery from Egypt. They have crossed over. They are in the promised land. Moses has received the law on the tablets and has taken the tablet to them. And the law that Moses gave them was a covenantal relationship between God and the people of Israel. That relationship was very responsive. The relationship goes like this: if you do this, I will do this for you. That's what God said to the children of Israel. If you do this, obey me and serve me, I will be your God. And there must be no other God besides me, because I, your God, is a jealous God. Those days, there was polytheism, the worship of many gods. People worship the God of the river, the God of the harvest, the God of fertility, the God of so many things. And they were like confused. So each God requires everything you want God to do for you. So you have to pray in different ways. But God said, no, you don't need to do that. You have to pray now to this one God who is the Alpha Omega, the great again and again, Yahweh. It goes to you and myself. When you have a relationship with God, nothing will ever lack in life. Amen to that.
Amen.
If you have a relationship with God, I mean a personal relationship with God, knowing God is serving Him, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Amen to that.
Amen.
If you have a God like Yahweh, Jehovah Jireh, no matter how difficult it may be, and God will supply your needs according to the scriptures in glory. Amen to that.
Amen.
It's the gospel passage connects from the Old Testament. So we prepare our hearts and minds during this 40 days. If you are closer, you will attend all. If you are far, depending on your distance, you will try to attend at least one or two in your lifetime. So the pilgrims have to travel early to get to the temple. And when they get to the temple before the feast of the Passover, they have to purify themselves to also cleanse themselves, prepare themselves for the Passover. So to connect, let the preparation of Easter and the purification of the body during the journey for the Passover with one another. Jesus just finished his first miracle in Cana. And he came out and tell you something, people say they're married and I see you. In fact, he said the one said that Jesus was going to deliver some money for us when you travel to Jerusalem. Jesus then set from the journey because he was born under the law, the Son of Man, and was obeying the law. The law requires each Jew to go and attend each of the feasts. When Jesus gets at the temple, John 2:13-22 gave us a rich detail of the scenery of what was transpiring at that time in the temple. He met merchants bustling between the cattle. He met money changers taking their money. He met pilgrims, worshippers, arranging with the priest. But what kind of animal to buy? Whether a goat or a lamb to pass the arranging? But Jesus, we saw that, becomes enraged. He puts up into a thing. The thing is, one of the God who doesn't want us to suffer inflicting on people by loving them. One of the God who wants you myself to live a good life will spoil your people's business. The complaint of Jesus is not that the sharp practices of the people, business in the kingdom, nor the reform of the ethical life was his major concern. His concern was the usage of the temple. You need to understand this. If you are not born of a Jew's descent, you are not a Jew. If you come from outside and give myself, we are all Gentiles. So, as conservative as they may be and selfish, the Jews have their own section, the temple itself, and they just build a court outside the temple referred to as the Gentile court. From the Kidron Valley, Mount Olive, they left the place and brought the business in the center of the Gentile school. So, Jesus thing is where the people worship them. With all these things you are doing. And so, Jesus says, how dare you? How dare you turn my father's house into an emporium? How dare you turn my father's house into a marketplace? He explains, rather some dignity. At the moment of prayers, there was a blowing of cattle and a bleating of sheep. Rather than contrition and brokenness, rather than a prolonged prayer, there was noise from the coming stream outside the temple. So Jesus attacks the financial system of the church that benefited the clergy because of the priests themselves were getting a percentage on the things that were sold. If you will bring your animal to a far as broken tree or sozo or bulu, when you reach there, will tell you your sheep. All your coat is blemished. It has stink on it. Even the money you sold, people didn't have to worry themselves. Since you don't have to buy it, they will buy within the court. Of course, in the court, they have special exchange rate. You know, you go to some restaurant and the place are already in the radio. You accept money and get out of the restaurant. So the folks who are changed according to their rate, and they will make profit on the food and make profit on the exchange rate. In the morning, when you took your dinara there, the dinara was considered tainted. The dinara had been changed into a shekel. And of course, they gave you a rate. All of these things, Jesus attacked the system of the Jewish people. And so Psalm 69 verse 9 tells us that the disciples saw that zeal for my father's house had consumed me. Malachi 3 verse 3 tells us that the Lord went down to the temple to seek those who look for him, and in that process he will refine them and make them better people. Jesus said, I will destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will rebuild it. We said, what? It took us only 6 days. You say in 3 years? The first temple was built by Solomon 1000 BC, but was destroyed by the Babylonian captivity. And in 586 BC, Herod the Great, for 46 years, rebuilt the temple. And Jesus is saying that he will destroy this temple. The Jews saw Jesus, they stood aghast and saw Jesus as a small poem, as a maniac who went in the temple things and threw things out of the temple. But why did I understand what Jesus was speaking to them in parables? That parable was, his body is the temple, and destruction is the cross that Jesus will have to carry. How will you kneel and fought and crucified for us? And if Jesus is the temple, we are the spiritual temple. And if we are the spiritual temple, my friends, then we meet the sacrifice every Sunday in a beautiful manner in which the priest chants, in a manner in which the priest sings the mass, in the royal way we want to receive the Eucharist. We all are schools in this temple. We can either build the temple or we can either shape the temple. What then will be your role? And so Jesus says, and I want to speak to you this morning, take these things out here. The question is, what things do I take out here? Those things of injustice and poverty in our nation today, the suppression and corruption that is taking place, and the church failed not to speak about it. Take these things out here. What things? The political behavior and activities. We want to turn the church into a political party. Take these things out here. Take these things out here because the church is not a clean church. If I don't bear initial change, you don't know me. If I don't not bear the sympathies for come there, then I'm not my type. If we met our father to get someone to go to a meeting, you just said you are not my type. If you can't afford to pay your dues, you cannot speak in a meeting. You cannot recognize your position because you don't have money. Take these things out here. Am I saying something that's going to church? What things do we take out of here? What things Jesus is telling us to take out of this church? The things that you think you know about me, you know now. You don't even know about yourself. You leave the law in your hand. When you talk about the next person and you look there and you tell the Spirit that you're there, take these things out of here. Because when you damage your own character, your character will be damaged and will be worse than you ever imagined. Take these things out of here. Take these things out of here, because in Campus Church, most of you can look in my face and are proud to be to say you were confirmed and baptized with Father Baker or a priest. When Father Kimba was rector, you know why? Because the church is the place that you receive your faith when Christ called you, the place where you were nourished, the place where you were schooled in Christian nutrition. Today you can stand and say you are a better woman, you are a better man because of what St. Thomas did for you to the grace of God.
Amen.
Take these things out of here.
Amen.
And so Paul says in Romans, as grand as Jesus, there are things that you and myself cannot do. We are prone to sin. Paul says, we are slaves to sin. That's something that you see around when you need to really say, that the devil fool you. But God is saying that that devil, no matter who you know, that devil will fool you. Because you will bear your own penalty for the sin that you commit. Not because God is willing to forgive us, to give us a license to sin every day. We must again. Those feelings of the fornication and adultery, they must be taken out of them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, you don't like it. But you can't have people hold their hand in the church. You probably pray it together. Just start acting in the name of Jesus. Because when two friends meet together, they become one. And you divide the church and think like a king in the name of Jesus. Take these feelings out of here. Because I know I am a cheater already, so I don't care if I'm preaching about the Lord, I put on my mind to say to you this morning. Those things must be removed in the name of Jesus. Amen. If I have the child, don't spoil the child in the name of Jesus. That child will be your own child. Disgust in the name of Jesus, or God will strike you in the name of Jesus. Take these things out of here. Those things of drunkenness, those things that in the church. You feel proud in your sin and put the shoulders in your head and some kind of king. Who are you? You are just a mortal man. Just a breath of life. God can take that breath and breathe for you. Take these things out of here. The soul says, shame our wanton selfish darkness. They are rich in things and poor in soul. Because they don't take these things out of here, this will miss the kingdom go. Are you being a small in church? You be proud, not speaking to your sister, but you walk on the communion rail to take communion. You think when you saw disrespectful to the elders of the church, and you are somehow beat and get a church squad, they fool you because your path leads to destruction. Take these things out of here. The exploitation and harassment. Take these things out of here, my friends. The gossip and the anger and the backbiting. Take these things out of here. They are something putting your hands in people's marriages. And the strength of the pastor and getting that not a prayer husband or prayer man. You stand among the person. Get these things out of here in the name of Jesus. Get these things out of here. It's not lawful. Get these things. Jesus will not break you. Jesus will not break the law. You will not bring God to break people out of here. You will break yourself into hell. If you think that you are going to get trophy out of here, your trophy leads to hell. No one is exempted. I'm going to save us as well as you, because we all need God's grace to save us from the crushes of sin and Satan. Are you okay in this morning, church? What things do we take out of here? What things? Those things that divide us, that bring divisiveness among us. Replace those things with love and unity and peace. Take these things out of here. Even me as a priest, if I'm not appetizing to the concerns, parishioners, if I don't care for them and look after them again, then I myself am going the wrong way. We must speak out. If George guy is doing the wrong thing, we must stand to his face and tell him to his face. If I don't care who is in leadership, or the chief justice, or the minister, or the senator, the church must speak out. It's time to speak out so that we are ready for moral conscience. Take these things out of here. A lot of people say, where is the church? In one of these, the church is a time for the church to speak. No one can buy the church, my friends. You can take away your gospel and your money, but the Holy Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I command you to speak the truth today. And I will speak the truth, because my Christ is so around, I say, all on the ground, the sinking sand. Take these things out of here. What things do we take out of here? Stop damaging your friend's character. You don't need damage somebody's character, your character will be damaged far better than the person. Take these things out of here. And then have somebody, don't fool them. Because when you fool them, God will also do the same to you and will fall flat on your face. Take these things out of here. What things? That's a question that keep lingering on our mind. Keep pondering. What things that Jesus talked about today? Take these things out of here. Stop dividing God's people, church. Unite God's people. Take these things out of here. Sometimes the people you take to be your enemies are your closest friends because they're telling you the truth. And those you take to be your enemies are your closest friends. Are you being this stupid one in this church? The people you think closer are the people who reach you harm. They come to take news and they take the news out and they amplify the news. Everybody tells their story. As soon as they enter the church, they know about you. Don't know about themselves. I want a business inside and a business.
Son is Jesus Christ the Lord. He gave his blood, he died for his church, and this church will stay no matter what, because this church has been blessed, and this church will prosper in the name of Jesus.
That's the word.
My friends, I got a woman, I'm going to come. Go and school. And Joshua 3:3 says, Joshua told the people, he said this. He said in his word, consecrate yourself, sanctify yourself, for tomorrow I will do wonders among you. Tomorrow I will bless you. In order to obtain that blessing, then you'll set your path straight. You'll put yourself in the rightful path. The day you celebrate somebody's downfall, somebody will celebrate your downfall. All we need to do is to pray for one another, because we are all in the flesh and weak and frail, and we all need the grace of God to sustain us. Pray for me, and I pray for you. That's what the church should be. Let's pray for one another. If you believe and I believe, the word will be saved. The Holy Spirit will come down and send us, and every person that is here this morning will be saved. And friends, I am about to close. I'd like to tell you that anything that brings a stumbling block in your way, it will be removed in the name of Jesus. I declare and decree, March has a moment of opportunities. March has a moment of favor. And the stress will never come your path. You will walk upright with your face in the air. You will come back and give testimony that I'll break the heart. God bless you, sustain you, keep you.
Thank you.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.